you know, I've done this kind of thing before, and it's been kind of more serious. And I thought, let's lighten up a little. So I said, phone Ian, let's lighten up. Let's get a little levity in there.
Lighten it up just a little bit.
You know, speaking of that whole era, though, there was something I really found funny when that whole British invasion happened, and all these bands were on the air from England, and that was, they never sang in their own dialect. They never sang with their own accents.
Oh, I know. Yeah, the Americans wanted to sound English, and the English wanted to sound American.
All the Brits had American accents. Now, I think this is dishonest. Can you imagine if Annie Lennox of the Eurythmics, who's from Scotland, see where I'm going with this?
Well, no. I think I know where you're headed, but go ahead and tell me.
If she had given us sweet dreams in her own dialect, it would have been like this. Sweet dreams are made of these. Who am I to disagree? This one's good. I've traveled the world and the seven seas. Everybody's looking for someone. Oh, get away. See, it wouldn't have worked.
No.
You really got me now. You got me so I can sleep at night. Oh yeah. You really got me now. You got me so I don't know what I'm doing. Oh yeah. You really got me now. You got me so I don't know what I'm doing. Oh yeah. Girl, you really got me now. You got me so I can't sleep at night. Oh yeah, you really got me now. You got me so I don't know what I'm doing. Set me free. I always wanna be by your side. Girl, you really got me now. You got me so I don't know what I'm doing.
Oh yeah, you really got me now. You got me so I don't know what I'm doing now.
Oh yeah, you really got me now. You got me so I can't sleep at night.
I thought. It's always nice to end rock and roll differently.
Good afternoon, Newsroom 11. Dave, the Queen's Park story is ready.
Mobile on the news.
Go ahead, one.
Approaching the access scene here now.
Connie, who's your interview with today?
Well, we have two chemists who have developed a kit for testing.
Yeah, it's a good lead story. Go with that.
And who wrote it?
I did.
Okay, we need a number for the McMaster security story.
Ready in 3, 2, 1. Cue Dan.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Dan McLean.
You've got your own ideas about business. You do things your way. So you don't work for a company. You are the company. You take the risks. You get the rewards. You put in 10, 12, 14 hours a day because sometimes that's what it takes. That's why there's this, The corporate card from American Express, with unique benefits for small business, like quarterly management reports to help you track where your money's going, automatic business travel assurance, including coverage for car rental theft and damage, flight delay, and baggage loss, preferred rates on car rentals and hotel accommodations. To acquire the corporate card, call 1-800-358-7000 or look for this display. It's a business card you'll be proud to put your name on and your company's name, because it does things a little differently, a little better, like you. The corporate card, from American Express to your success.
I remember doing Right Before My Eyes in Red Deer, and the arena had it was a corrugated metal roof. And just as I started into the song, every day I sit beside you, a hailstorm hit.
No.
As I... And people were fleeing from the building. They finally done it. The bomb's dropped. It just was so loud, the whole song fell apart.
Come on, is that really true?
True story.
Oh, jeez.
True story. Especially for you, I told this story.
That'll make a perfect lead-in to, like, the tune.
It could be.
Like, it was a good little anecdote.
Because it mentioned the song name right before my eyes, and Red Deer, which is also mentioned in the song.
Milk that last note.
It goes for a long time.
That was way better.
Yeah.
Mondo better. We're out on the floor and we're trying to have some sort of semblance of intelligence, and Ian launches into one of his routines. So this actually, ladies and gentlemen, Ian Thomas doing his routine about woofers and tweeters.
This actually came out of a conversation with a dear friend of mine named Tim Tickner, and we were thinking, you know,
Can you imagine if all the VU meters, which are these little windows there with the little knobs that go up and down to tell you when you're getting too loud.
Yes.
Before these had been invented, recording sessions, of course, there wouldn't be these windows on the desk.
No.
Much like in a mine.
No.
Remember in a mine they'd have a canary down there.
Yes.
So if there was a poisonous gas and the canary fell over, they knew to get out.
Right.
Well, it's my premise and my belief that before the VU meter, they used to strap little budgies to the high end of the speaker, hence the name tweeter, and small dogs, like the Pekingese, to the low end speaker, hence the name woofer. And you could tell if you were too loud because the budgie's head would go like this. Now, if it had been one of your sessions with Triumph playing metal, you would have gone through, I reckon, two, maybe three shoeboxfuls of budgies.
Easy.
A couple of tractor trailer loads.
And I would think at least two Pekingese, maybe a poodle.
True.
It's all true. Yes. Now they got these little windows, and the SPCA is very happy indeed.
I want that.
Just imagine.
Tomorrow, Dr. Lisa DeVito is a resident psychiatrist, and this is her first patient, a disturbed boy with a dark past.
I scare you, don't I?
Oh, wow.
Why would you want to scare me?
If I can't love you, I gotta do something.
Starring Melissa Gilbert, Woody Harrelson, and Fernando Lopez.
You let me be hurt.
Leave me alone!
The shattering drama Killer Instinct, tomorrow on Channel 11.
You've left the place you've known for years. You're starting out anew.
Let's see.
Hello.
Hi, we're the Stevens.
We moved into the Henderson place.
New friends in IDA.
Need lots of things to get that house ready.
Helping people find a way. We care at IDA.
Thanks for everything. We need a bucket.
Oh, they didn't tell you about the leaky roof.
You've got a friend at IDA.
Have you got anything for a headache?
Toronto's Modern Rock, FM 102. First on the block with the hottest new rock. FM 102 is more back-to-back modern rock hits.
And it's been 5 long years and I love you just.
Where the hottest new music is always heard first. Toronto's Modern Rock, FM 102, CFNY. Turn it on now.
While taping, the staff and guests of In Session have enjoyed the world-class treatment and old-world charm provided by the Royal Connaught Hotel. The Royal Connaught, the place to stay in Hamilton.
I mean, yeah. There was that thing that British rock groups did that I loved when I was sort of headed from the Led Zeppelin phase across and into becoming an adult. There was this, like, bands like Yes and Genesis, and that was a very sort of European classical music kind of
a... It was a hybrid.
Yeah, and I was really into that. And the American version of that was more like Return to Forever and, you know, Romantic Warrior and that kind of stuff, which I like too, but...
So were you a big Zeppelin fan?
Oh, yeah. Well, Triumph was a Zepp copy band. I mean, we used to play the bars and...
Zeppelin, for me, I just have sort of discovered through my daughter. When all that was going on, I was in my big sort of vocal phase where... I loved, you know, stuff like The Association, The Beach Boys, and then Crosby, Stills, and Nash came
All on. Vocal stuff, right?
It was vocal stuff that fascinated me. So, you know, when I heard, you know, the whole Led
Zeppelin.
You know, well, there wasn't very many vocals in that for me.
No, it's a different approach. See, you sort of come at things because you're a singer-songwriter and primarily a songwriter, so you're more of a sort of a parts-oriented kind of a guy.
I said you should remember.
Knott's Landing returns next Wednesday at 10. Celebrate Beverly Hills Diamond Jubilee next on Channel 11.
Bobby lived hard and